thanks for inviting us in. We want to begin with this story that has captivated the nation tonight. A manhunt for an Alabama fugitive and a jail officer. Tonight we've learned that jail officer died after shooting herself during a police chase that ended in Evansville. Vicky White and Casey White have been on the run since April 29th. They have the same last name, but they are not related. Casey White was convicted of attempted murder in Alabama. Vicky White helped him escape from a county jail in that state. She was in a management position in the jail as the assistant director of corrections. She planned on retiring. In fact, her last scheduled day at work was the day they disappeared. Our Emily Longnecker takes us step by step tonight of what started in Alabama and ended here in Indiana.
A lot of relief tonight among law enforcement that the search for these two fugitives is over and that no one searching for them or members of the public were hurt in the process.
10 days after U.S. Marshals say this woman, Vicky White, a corrections officer at an Alabama detention facility, helped an accused murderer, Casey White, with the same last name but no relation, escape from custody. The search for the fugitives ended with a car crash between the couple and U.S. Marshals in Evansville.
Actually collided with them to try to end the pursuit. When this occurred, the female driver of the vehicle shot herself and the passenger was injured. Not too seriously. They've both been taken to local hospitals to be examined for their injuries.
Vicky White died later Monday evening. U.S. Marshals had been looking for the couple since April 29th when the Sheriff's Department in Lauderdale County, Alabama, released this surveillance video. It shows Vicky White on her last day of work as a corrections officer before retirement, leading a handcuffed Casey White out of the corrections facility and into a patrol car. Investigators say Vicky White was supposed to be taking Casey White for a mental health evaluation. Casey White was set to stand trial this summer, charged with stabbing a 58-year-old woman to death. He was already serving a sentence for armed robbery and attempted murder. According to investigators, there was no appointment, though, and the couple ditched the patrol car and made their way to Tennessee in this car, which police found abandoned hours later. Then, 6 days ago, a tip in Evansville, Indiana, video surveillance showed a man believed to be Casey White at a local car wash with a black Ford 150 pickup truck. That tip brought U.S. Marshals to southern Indiana. Monday, another lead after the couple was spotted in this Cadillac still in Evansville. Investigators can't say why two people running from the law would have stayed put in one place for several days.
With criminals and criminal minds, they're very unpredictable.
Something that played out Monday afternoon when the couple led law enforcement on a chase before crashing, with Vicky White, say investigators, shooting herself as it ended. Police say Casey White wasn't seriously injured.
We got a dangerous man off the street today. He is never going to see the light of day again. And, you know, that's a good thing for not just our community, but that's a good thing for this country.
Well, since he was caught in Indiana, many of you have been asking, what if an inmate escapes in the state? Well, here's what the Department of Corrections does to keep the public up to date. It has an automated system to let residents know when someone escapes from a jail or prison near them. This system has been around since July of 2010. If an escape does happen, anyone registered will get detailed information about the inmate and the time of the escape. You do have to register, though, to receive them. So if you'd like to receive these alerts, head over to WTHR.com. And that wraps up tonight's big story.